by name. I want to say hello to Casey and to Jeremy and to Rachel and to Nick and Hunter and Corinne and Stacy and Jordan. I bet you all looking real nice. Gals have pretty dresses on, got your flowers. The guys, you've cleaned up real nice, I'm sure. In fact, you probably look even older than you've ever looked before. Well, this is an important day for you. And I wish I could be with you, but I can't. I've got to be doing something else. This is a day to honor you here in Romeo. And I want you to be praying for me, because about the time that you are sitting in these pews, I'm going to be putting the finishing touches on a sermon for my Uncle Keith, who was a World War II veteran, served in the Pacific, and was just a great man, and I hope I can have words to honor him. But now we're here to honor you, to share with you in this wonderful day. And let me see if you can remember this. Here is that stepping stone. Some of you have heard me talk about this when you were in confirmation and all the way back through Sunday school. We're all part of a journey of faith, all of us together. And this is a significant part of your journey. And so I want to applaud you and just say how proud I am of you. Also to let you know that I really had a great time working with you. You really didn't give me much of a problem through these 3 years, you know. We had some fun. We also had some serious talks, and it was just a pleasure to be your pastor, and it was a pleasure to be with you as a teacher of the faith. Now, one thing, during confirmation and at the service of confirmation, very often it's been a tradition to give each person being confirmed a Bible passage. But as I thought of the last few weeks that we shared together, I decided there was one passage that is so important right now in your lives that I decided to make it for the entire class. So here it is. Now, don't worry about having to copy it down, because it's going to be written on your confirmation certificates. It's from the Gospel of John, chapter 17, verses 11 and 15 through 17. This is a warmly intimate passage where Jesus is talking with his Father, but he's talking to him about his disciples, because he's going to leave them, and he knows he's going to leave them, and he's trying to get them ready for his leaving, but he's also saying to his Father what he has done with these disciples. And so this is the words of Jesus. He says to his Father, "And now I am coming to you. I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. Holy Father, keep them safe by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one just as you and I are. I do not ask you to take them out of the world, but I do ask you to keep them safe from the evil one. Just as I do not belong to the world, they do not belong to the world. Dedicate them to yourself by means of the truth. Your word is truth." I picked that text because just a few weeks ago, we were sitting together in the gym, and we talked about a very tragic thing that occurred. For many of you, one of your classmates tried to take her own life. And so we talked about that and talked about the challenges facing you. And your challenges are many. It's an exciting thing, and as I did my interviews with you, many of you were excited about your futures. And one of the things is you have more choices than I think any generation has ever had. So many choices and so much information coming at you from so many directions. But there's also risk. Many years ago, I heard a writer describe growing up and the time of adolescence to adulthood as kind of like walking through a minefield. And you got to watch and have your wits about you so you don't step on a mine and it blows up in your face. I think for you, you have so many choices. that minefield is just littered with mines. And the challenge is to make it through, to make good choices in your lives so that you don't step on something that's going to blow up in your face. And that's why I came back to this text for you. Because Jesus is saying, and I'm going to unwrap it with you a little bit now. He is saying to his Father, okay, I have kept these disciples of mine safe. All right? And I'm not asking you to take them out of the world. Now, we will live in the world. You will live in the world. But Jesus is asking his Father to keep them safe. Your parents and everybody here this day that are so proud of you also want you to be safe. But how can we be safe? Right? How can we know? How can we not maybe lose faith or go down the wrong trail or just get involved in something that will blow up in our faces? Okay? One way is by being connected to God and the church. I said to all of you in your individual interviews that I wanted you to see this church, especially these years as you go through high school, as a safe place. As a place you could come, you could be yourself, you could feel accepted. And if you needed someone to talk to, there would be people here. I want you to remember that. But there's also something else in this text. You know, Jesus says that we're in the world, but we don't belong to the world. Right? We have something else to help us besides this world. And that's God. Sometimes you feel good. Sometimes you feel like you have great faith. But your feelings alone aren't going to be enough. That's when you can return to the Word of God. When you turn to Scripture, when you turn to the Bible, when you read about Jesus, what you're going to read about, and I hope, believe and experience, is a God who loves you beyond all comprehension, and will be with you all the days of your lives. So hold on to that thought this day and just enjoy the day and enjoy the rest of this service. And I once again say how proud I am of you. And God bless you and keep you. And I'll see you when I get back in.